A virtual world where people would use digital avatars to live, work, and play online. He called it the metaverse.
This piece of land with Snoop Dogg's face on it is owned by the rapper. He's building a virtual mansion on it.
Metaverse is catching on, and the people are going crazy for it. But one of the biggest impacts of it is that it is changing and shifting industries. From, of course, gaming and entertainment, to tourism, to workspaces, and even architecture. I had made a whole video about how architecture will change with the onset of the metaverse. But the truth is, it has been evolving for quite some time.
Companies like Meta, aka Facebook, are betting billions of dollars on the hope that virtual reality is the future of human interaction.
The technologies that make up the metaverse, mainly VR, AR, MR, and XR, have been here for quite some time. It is only recently that they've got this makeover and have come under the umbrella term of the metaverse. And suddenly, so many people have joined the bandwagon. Today in this video, we are exploring architects who've already taken steps towards a metaverse before it became a mainstream thing. We are going to be looking at three stories where the underlying technologies of the metaverse have been used to change how we design, construct, and perceive architecture. Welcome to Blessed Arch, and today on this video, we are talking about the architects of the metaverse. When I say the word metaverse, what might come to your head is this digital animated world full of saturated colors, interactive things, and flying advertisements. Basically, people think the metaverse will be a completely virtual reality that can be experienced by different gadgets. This is exactly the kind of metaverse that people over at companies like Facebook are trying to create.
These companies just decided to move us all into the metaverse like they're putting their grandma into a nursing home. Sorry, Nana, you have to live in the computer now.
But the thing is, this world of Facebook will most probably be very close to our reality. Basically, it might look like a combination of the world you already live in with Instagram. It might feel exciting because of its underlying technology, but maybe not so much in its design. And the reason for that might just be that architects are not at the core of this new world building. But what if they were? What if architects could create a digital world where achieving the impossible might just be any other day?
But I definitely think that moving forward, you know, metaverse as a whole, there's so many other possibilities within what we can do with this space. You know, how can that be scripted or coded into what we want to do in it?
This is Mateus Tenkachi. He's the co-founder of the design firm Sunken Blimp, and he has created this virtual stage, a VR space where people from all over the world can come together, connect, and share ideas.
So the stage would be this virtual space where we can come together, host conversations, presentations, and start experimenting on how to actually engage with a group of people in virtual reality, which is a conversation that's been going on for a while, and how to present, right? Even presenting projects, like we present on architecture and do reviews and all of that. How do you do that in a virtual space where the rules of physics and how things can actually operate can be completely different?
So yes, the idea of meeting virtually is not novel, but as we move towards a virtual reality for all, the design of this new world does matter. Similar to how the design of the built environment around you matters.
From a design standpoint, it's one single surface that bands around and makes the audience and makes the stage and makes the covering, makes the floors. And there's no really like a difference between what stage, what's floor, what's audience. Everything flows together. So it gives at least the feeling that, you know, you can walk up the stage at any point. You know, presenters and audience have the same role in this. So that is what we started from.
And this vision of his is not just limited to this one stage. This, as he says, is version one.
Different than an architectural project building a physical building, you get people's experience when the job is done. And then, you know, you can take that as information and move on and, you know, the knowledge for the next project. But now, in something like this, you can take the feedback and keep updating and reiterating the project because, you know, it's a different approach. It's an ongoing, you know, space creation in a way.
What's fascinating is that at the center of this stage, the main crux of it is design. He constantly works on improving and changing his versions, updating them to to fit the needs of the users.
The question of even accessibility in design, right? In physical life, right? In the physical world, we have accessibility in terms of people with disabilities. So let's say wheelchairs, that's the classic example, right? Buildings have to have access for those who cannot, you know, climb up the stairs. However, in the metaverse or virtual spaces, you know, a wheelchair, for example, is not a problem, right? You could have a staircase. However, there's other types of accessibility issues that should be taken into consideration. And right now, it's not really the main point of conversation in virtual spaces. However, some people are more, you know, sensitive to strobe lights, you know, having seizures with strobe lights. And then some materials or some virtual spaces that have, you know, lights flashing or materials flickering, that could cause problems. And what we're talking about here is that this virtual spaces could know who you are based on your profile. And that space could be different for you based on your, you know, requirements or preferences. So maybe disability is not designing a space that serves all, but designing a system that can modify depending on what you need.
At the end of the day, the profession of architecture is about solving problems through design. In a virtual world, the problems will be different, and so will the solutions. So even in this world of endless possibilities, you still have restrictions, just like the physical world. And hopefully, as we move towards a better and better virtual reality, we'll have more and more architects get more creative with their creations. But after seeing this project, the design stage, and hearing all the news about this metaverse, a new question comes to mind. Will the new world order be completely virtual? Now hey, before we move ahead, I actually wanted to talk to you about the sponsors of today's video, 1:2x. Now 1:2x is a platform that can give you the digital skills that one requires to be an architect. They have an array of courses that can teach you different skill sets for your career. One of these is their BIM course. Now BIM is to the architecture industry what Metaverse is to the tech industry. With 1:2x's BIM course, you can learn from industry professionals working in top firms and also get to work on a live project. And the best part is after you're done, they give you placement support as well. So if you want to take your career to the next level, do check out 1:2x. You can find their links in the description. And now, let's get back to our video.
This is it. I'm going into the ultranet to save my daughter.
Just like we spend hours and hours in a day on our phones and computers, will we also do it in the new virtual realm? And will more and more architects start gravitating towards building these new and fantastic forms? Will the profession start getting dominated by the so-called virtual architects? Well, some people think not. For one, the technologies that will make it immersive and more easily accessible are a few years away.
But Cambria will be a completely new, advanced, and high-end product, and it'll be at the higher end of the price spectrum too.
But there are also people who see this metaverse as something very different. They do not see it as a completely new world that you just escape to. They actually see it as a new layer of reality that can be added over the existing one. Imagine architecture that blends with technology to create immersive solutions. For example, what if me, a client, could completely experience what my new space will look like instead of just seeing a few renders on a computer screen? Well, this is exactly what a firm in India tried to do for their clients. This is ARPM Design and Research from Gurgaon, India. Their experiment with the underlying technologies of the metaverse actually happened out of necessity.
आज रात 12 बजे से संपूर्ण देश में संपूर्ण लॉकडाउन होने जा रहा है.
India has become the latest and largest country to introduce a nationwide lockdown in the fight against the coronavirus.
Now the world changed in the year 2020 and the field of architecture was affected as well. For these guys, the problem with their latest project is that they could not travel to the site and had only seen it once. As a designer, we tend to spend time at sites, brainstorm ideas, get the feel of the entire space before we can redesign it. But since going to the site was not physically possible, they brought the site to them.
We worked entirely remotely, and for that, to aid that process, sort of, we started using AR. It was first easier to actually feel the space ourselves as architects, walk around the space and actually get a feel for how large the corridor width is, how large the doors are, what the sizes of different windows and openings are. And once we got a feel for the space, we were able to then better design for it.
And also, in the same way that they brought the site to them, they got the final design to the clients.
Doing the usual architectural visualization step and kind of rendering out images and walkthrough videos and stuff like that, we instead took this model into AR again, the final design output that we came up with, and allowed the client to actually walk through the site as if they were walking through the final design. They were able to walk around and understand what the final site would feel like rather than just look like.
One of the reasons I wanted to bring this story to you is to tell you that the technology behind it is not years away. It is here now, and it's slowly catching on. So the metaverse might not just mean futuristic and fantastic forms. It might mean new ways of looking at and aiding processes that architects take part in right now. There are loads of companies who've started giving virtual immersive tours to their clients of their future designs or real estate projects. And as we move ahead in the next decade, this is going to become more mainstream all over the world. But can this go beyond just the designing stage? There was this one professor back in architecture school, and he used to say, architecture is not just about designing beautiful buildings, it is also about constructing them. Details, he used to say, details are important. So when we talk about the metaverse, will it just remain till the design stage, building these fantastic forms and viewing them? Or can it actually become an active part of the construction process? Well, turns out it can. This is the use of digital reality to aid in the construction of our real world. And the company behind this is Fologram. I actually sat down with the founders to understand more of what they do.
So Fologram is a tool for building mixed reality applications in Rhino and Grasshopper, which lets you skip the learning curve of game engines like Unity for building simple AR apps. We made Fologram mostly so that creatives like architects, engineers, artists, students that make things could get stuck into building all of the kind of crazy ideas that they had for mixed reality without needing to go learn to code and things like that.
I wanted to go deeper into their work to understand how their technology is helping the construction sector. We talked about one of their recent projects, the Hobart Hospital development.
Anyone working with 3D models can use Fologram to build in augmented reality. This includes bricklayers such as Colin from Old Brick, who are now comfortable in using it in their challenging day-to-day projects.
Basically, the main thing around the Hobart Hospital was the complexity of the layout of these brick benches. So it was a sort of 15-story tower. They had to build these brick benches over multiple levels. And the traditional way to lay that out is extremely complex because you basically have all these curved arches that need to connect. And so the traditional way to do it, you basically have, you use a holotime lane setting out, and then you have one brick layer that starts, I guess, at the head of the snake and then proceeds to go along and in a very trial and error fashion, connect the bricks together. Because obviously with a curve, there's all a whole lot of different cutted bricks they need to do. And it really is a case where it's one brick layer with a couple of apprentices that is chopping up bricks and he's just trying to put the jigsaw together. Where Fologram completely changed the game for that is that we provided not only the cutting patterns that they had to see, so they could see what bricks they needed to cut, and so they could prepare those in advance or concurrently when that's going on and bringing those bricks up. And so it's literally like, all right, here's the J bricks here for, or here's the K bricks for the bricklayer. They could pick it up, and then with the headset they could see exactly where that brick needed to be placed.
A simple interface allows the bricklayers to view each course they're on and what cut brick types are required in that moment.
So basically, they were able to guide the bricklayers to create complex geometries in a simple and easy manner. The word democratizing complexity is what came to my mind when we were chatting. So metaverse as a whole might be a few years away, and we will see what it can truly do. But clearly the technologies that the metaverse is relying on are here now, and they are helping drive and evolve the profession of architecture. Whether it is creating a completely new immersive world, changing the design process, or becoming a part of the construction, the future of the metaverse is bound and limited only by people's capabilities and their imaginations. I, for one, am excited to see these new worlds or see the change in our existing one. And I'm glad that people driving these are architects, or should we call them architects of the metaverse. And there you have it, guys, the architects of the metaverse. Of course, this was the first of many such stories that I will be bringing to you in the coming months. But I wanted to know your thoughts. What do you think about these projects and what the metaverse will mean for the architects? Also, I would like to thank everybody who was a part of this video. And a special thanks to all of this channel's patrons who have helped support this channel via Patreon and via channel memberships. If you wish to support it as well, you can find the link for both channel memberships and the Patreon link in the description below. Or you could also click the join button. Everybody who was featured on this channel today, you can find their details and how to reach out to them in the description below. As always, don't forget to give this video a thumbs up, to share this video, and to subscribe to Blessed Arc. I will see you guys soon with more such content. Until then, bye-bye.